It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go.
Screw you, Bing. Take a look in the go to hell. Who do you think you are? Hey, how was your drive?
I'm Jewish, so it's fine.
What does that even mean?
I comfortably spent $8 on MinPass. So it was fine. $8.
What does that have to do with you being Jewish?
We're known to be tight with our money.
Let's just go with that.
And this Christmas theme song is making me uncomfortable. So everything's going to be about. I'm going to speak.
Are you declaring a war on Christmas?
Yeah. Let's create a new
damn right
thing for Jewish people. They're good. They're just good in bad weather.
Hey, that's not Colleen.
No.
What the heck?
She's not Jewish. She couldn't afford.
Jennifer
I couldn't afford it.
Playing the role of Colleen Justice will be
that's
Jennifer.
Right. That's right.
The luckiest woman in Minnesota as she's married to Rusty Gatenby.
Oh, this just got weird.
High five around the room. Jim Cunningham is here. We're going to be talking lots of things. Welcome, Jim. You made it. I was worried.
No, I live in St. Paul.
I've heard of St. Paul.
Yeah,
it's that way.
Mostly a secret. We don't want a lot of people there.
But it's so miles, though. How many miles away is that?
You know, it took me about 25 minutes to get over. I kind of came the back roads, as you do when the snow flies.
There's not many that get you across the river, though. What's your back road across the river?
I can't get into it with you. I'm a Mason. I have secrets, and I'm not sharing the back road story with you.
Not even with our Jew? You won't even tell him?
Can't do it. Are you a Mason? Yeah. No.
No. No, I don't think we can do Masons. That's
no. I can't share.
We're going to be talking about how it's a wonderful life. I want to catch up with your career because you've been active in the Twin Cities, shall we say, theater scene?
Yeah, I guess theater scene works for me. It's among the things I do.
Yeah, so, and folks who watch to the Twins, how about those Twins? They see him working his butt off out there in the stadium. First, we want to also continue to thank our friends at St. Jude. Here's a message from Jennifer Aniston. Ooh.
Kaylee keeps a journal as she fights brain cancer.
I wish I wasn't different than other kids.
But you're getting so much better. Because St. Jude Children's Research Hospital has created a special treatment giving Kaylee and kids like her across America the best chance of survival.
I want to write, "My cancer is gone."
Oh, honey, St. Jude has doubled those chances for you.
Donate now at stjude.org or shop wherever you see the St. Jude logo.
You know, I like Marlo Thomas, but when did she start to sound like Burgess Meredith? I mean, she's still a handsome lady, but she's still that girl to me. And she's doing a wonderful work at St. Jude. We're going to be talking about them. Throughout, they got a big gala coming up for the Golden Globes. But in the meantime, shall we get this show started, shall we? Let's start this show.
Congratulations. You found the Twin Cities hit show.
Very well. Where do I begin?
Ladies and gentlemen, can I please have your attention?
You're lucky to be here.
Thank you, sir.
Reach for this one.
And now, a real hit show.
This is outrageous.
Live from the Twin Cities.
Oh, is this your snowbank?
No. Who are you?
It's the Twin Cities hit show.
You disturbed me for the very last time.
Coming to you live from the Alive and Social Network studios.
In the whole vast configuration of things, I'd say you were nothing but a scurvy little spider. And that goes for you, too.
And now, let's get this hit show started.
So I'm probably going to be outnumbered. Because after Thanksgiving, I like putting up the tree. It's game on. Listening to the Christmas music. Being a Jewish person, does this? You're like, no, no. Does Christmas music bother you? Are you like?
It drives me nuts, and I hate it. My ex-wife crammed it down my throat, and my mother-in-law. It was my favorite story about my mother-in-law.
Yeah.
When I first met her, she goes, "Oh, you're Jewish. I had a Jewish friend in high school." Like, that doesn't make you relatable. That makes you anti-Semitic. You haven't met a Jewish person you've liked in the last 50 years enough to say, "This is my Jewish friend?"
Oh,
come on.
I'm trying to find some of my Christmas music because I was full on with the Christmas music. And
I will hit mute.
My children and my lovely wife said, "Not yet. Turner, that's too
much."
That's
right. That's right.
Thank you.
And I pointed out, there are some people that cannot stand the sound at all. It sends them into a deep depression. Let's just turn it off.
Yes.
Oh, I was trying to find. Here we go.
Well, you know why?
Oh, let's play some then.
It's all about alienation, because I've never felt part of any of this, and you can't fake it. Oh, I'm going to celebrate Christ. You can't fake that. Depresses me.
You don't sing along to Away in the Manger? You and your...
Ugh. Gag.
Jim, help me out. I'm hoping you're on my side.
Yeah, I am, actually. I'm your side, yeah. We at my little house with the happy people in St. Paul, we kind of mark the day when the radio stations make the full-on switch to all Christmas all the time.
Thank you.
We're waiting with bated breath, and I have an inside track as to when that's going to happen. I usually get some inside information about when, and we all gather around the radio and watch it go from Bob Marley.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely. We're full on. We did Thanksgiving three times over the weekend.
Yeah, nice.
Wow. We went to Sound of Music at the Riverview Theater on Friday. We did Thanksgiving again on Saturday. We got our Christmas tree already.
Yeah. Oh, ours went up Friday. I'm leading the charge. I'm dragging them with me.
Oh yeah.
But then we gather around. We play card games and board games, and I have the 24/7 Christmas going. And then at one point, Jennifer finally said,
"Enough."
Enough. And then my kids chimed in, "Yeah, turn that crap off." Yeah. And I'm like, "What?"
Yep.
They go, "It's not even, there's plenty of time to play Christmas, Dad. It just started." I'm like, "Yeah, now it's the game time."
It just don't feel like they ever come out with new hits. It's just always the same.
Or any hits for that matter.
It's the same stuff over and over again. It's just somebody else singing it.
You people.
I control the volume on this show.
I did specify.
Huh? What?
There we go. Much better. I got the mute button.
I did say the Muppets Christmas is funny.
Muppets Christmas?
But you can only hear that so many times.
Weird Al has one, and being the way things are in the world, have you heard Weird Al's Christmas song?
I probably have, but I can't I can't quote from it.
Well, give that one.
We'll let this go through the first chorus.
Jingle bells.
Yeah. It's a couple of seasons old at this point, but it rings truer these days, truer than ever. Christmas at Ground Zero by Weird Al.
Oh, my God, Al. Al's getting a little edgy. I like that.
Sing along, everyone.
It's Christmas at Ground Zero. There's music in the air. The sleigh bells are ringing and the carolers are singing while the air raid sirens blare. It's Christmas at Ground Zero. All humanity.
Okay, then.
No more time for last minute shopping.
Hey.
It's time to face your final destiny.
Okay.
You know where that stuff comes from?
Huh?
That comes from the people that don't want Christmas music the day after Thanksgiving. That's where that comes from.
Yeah, it's that spirit.
You have yourselves to blame.
I'll buy that. Our own Brian Miller did a bit on Saturday night about the Yule log. You know, it's on 24/7.
Yeah, that's an old Hubbard thing at Channel 45.
Yeah, and now you can get it on Netflix.
Oh, so it's just, seriously?
Yeah, he goes, but it's so exciting to sit around and wait. Wait, here comes the hand. Here comes the hand. And they don't even do anything special with the hand. It's like this creepy, hairy hand going in, rearranging the logs.
Adjust the log. We had a thing when we were with our mighty morning show over there on 5, Emmy Award winning, multiple Emmy Award winning, and we would always complain we couldn't get advertising. We wanted an ad campaign saying, you know, watch Eyewitness News Morning. And then the Yule log, every year without fail, would have this huge campaign for a flaming log. Even the Yule log gets more love than we do. But I guess he got bigger ratings than we do. You know who's getting a lot of love right now? Did you watch the game?
No. I can't. I have to pay extra to watch the stupid Gopher game. I haven't seen it all season.
I studied.
This is the Vikings, by the way.
Oh, yeah. Oh, God. Sorry. I was... I saw that one. I saw that one. Sorry.
Was part of your weekend the Viking game?
Absolutely was not. We were doing all kinds of... my son is home from St. John's for the weekend. So
I'm a Tommy, so screw you.
Yeah, well...
That was a big game.
That's where all Jews go, St. Thomas.
St. Thomas had a big weekend.
Yeah, they did. Yeah.
Against St. John's.
Yeah, they did.
They're going to be the national champs.
Yeah.
You heard it here first.
We're the first year where we could turn into something.
So why did you avoid? You were busy with family.
Like, you know, there was just all kinds of. Now I need a haircut, and now is it possible to mail things today?
Hey, I got bad news for you. You still need a haircut.
Yeah, exactly.
So. Yeah, that Vikings game was cool.
The Vikings are number one.
Yes,
you know the Packers. Thank you. Lost on Thanksgiving. Yes. That was part of our Thanksgiving.
And
was watching
AP's
me
back. What a game!
I know. See, it works. Yeah. I told it a couple of shows prior. We had one of our sports guys on. I said, "You can thank me. The reason that AP is winning is every time he gets the ball, I scream at the TV, 'You suck!'" And then he does well.
He gets angry.
And then
he's
an
angry runner.
So he goes into beast mode.
My sons now look at me, waiting for that. Like, I oblige. You suck. Sometimes not with this guy. You know, you suck. We are. But then he breaks out for a 70-yard run.
Yeah, he didn't
what
have
was the final yesterday?
30 to 13.
Yeah, something. They kept it.
No, they came back. It was 30 to 19 or something, or 20.
It's very similar to the St. Thomas St. John score. It was 38-19, and they came back. It was all St. Thomas until the last quarter.
Yeah, well, St. Thomas rarely wins against St. John's.
We got a soundbite from Coach Zimmer. Hold on.
You can win a game many ways, many ways. DJ, I was happy when they kicked the goddamn ball to him.
That's Jerry Burns.
Whoops. Oh. Wrong button.
Sorry.
Every time I hear that trumpety music, I assume it's college football. That's why I go into Gopher.
Oh no. That's the Skull Vikings.
Yeah. Gophers suck this year all of a sudden.
We're going to be talking about It's a Wonderful Life, but first we got an update. Yeah, it's not so wonderful out there in the roadways, and I guess there's more to come. The snow is just beginning. Here's from CCO and what we need to know, evidently.
It's going to be a challenge. This will be the first snow of the year in the metro area. It's a big deal, and I think folks need to start preparing themselves mentally.
We're in Minnesota, and in Minnesota we're supposed to have snow.
It's coming, and MnDOT urges drivers to make any preps they may have put off.
Are your wipers good? Do you have the blue juice in the blue reservoir juice inside your juice for your windshield wipers?
Are juice blue?
Yeah. This whole thing is the... Could you pick more...
Are you one of the blue Jews? Because I got
blue.
A check, evidently.
This whole season I'm blue, as evidenced by my statement.
Blue Jews, check.
Do you have a brush in your car to brush the snow off?
At this point this winter, we've had 1.3 inches of snow in the metro.
Losers.
Last winter, by this time, we already had 9.4 inches.
Yeah.
That's closer to average.
We had some snow come in early last week.
So
we had been, we did some pre-treating prior to that. And we put some salt down then. So there is residual salt on the roadways.
Kevin Gutnick hopes the snow won't hit hardest during rush hour.
Too late.
Our plows can only move so fast. They can only move as fast as the traffic is moving.
Oh, well, fix them. Outside
is okay, wow, there's some powerful info. First of all, we have the one Minnesota lady saying, "No, this is Minnesota. It's going to snow." And then you have him saying, "No, on the roads, it's only going to move as fast as traffic will go. So put on your boots."
That's why we're here, Chuck. That's why the Twin Cities Hit Show is here, so we can give that information so that life becomes wonderful.
For the record, I tried to cancel today's show, and Rusty wouldn't let me. I'm like, I'm not going to make it. Yes, you are.
Yeah. Well, when you called in, that's why I jumped out of bed. I'm like,
We're professionals. So do we want snow? Show of hands, voice it out, actually. It does work on radio. Answer it. We want snow, right?
0 to 4. No, how does that work?
No.
No.
Again, Thanksgiving's happened. No. Bring the snow
It's going to split the exact same way as Christmas just did.
Yeah, right?
Half the room, half the room.
Thanksgiving's
you know
done. Bring on the snow. If it's going to be cold, and it's, you know, it's going to be cold, have snow.
Through January 1st, I'm all for it.
I think I was
January 2nd, it can be done.
You turn quickly January 2nd.
Yeah.
You don't ski or snowmobile or anything?
No.
check of your Rolodex.
I was going mentally through it. I can ice skate pretty well.
Yeah.
And I will go out to the Roseville Oval. You probably don't know anything about
that. The Rose Memorial Oval.
Well, I guess you do.
Yeah.
I'm surprised it's you that knows that.
I was a Roseville policeman, and we had to turn in our guns because we couldn't afford them so that they could build that stupid oval.
Is that right?
Yeah. We had 10 of us riding around in one car to save money so they could build that stupid oval.
Well, it was worth it.
Yeah.
But
the skaters are
You
happy.
Must have looked awesome if you showed up to the Schreider Circus.
Clown car. Hello, 911. Still ringing. Budget cuts. Oval.
So you grew up Minnesota. You're a Minnesota guy.
Oh, yeah. All my life. St. Paul. Still there.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Where in St. Paul, roughly?
I grew up in Highland Park.
Me too.
Where?
The ghetto also. Yeah, dangerous.
Yeah. There were a lot of you in my neighborhood.
Yeah, a lot of you. Yeah.
Blue Jews.
Yeah, that's I like that's the joke. There's two kinds of people that grow up in Highland Park, Jews and Catholics.
I'm the other.
Yeah, I got beat up a lot by Catholics in high school.
Did you really?
Why?
No.
Not because of his religion, because he's an asshole. That's why. That's why.
Jesus is a myth. Oh, sorry. Did that make you angry?
Did you go to Highland Park?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, do you too?
Creighton.
You did?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Probably long before you did, though.
Yeah, well, I was class of 68.
Really?
No.
Yeah, I was class 88. Of 59.
Oh, see?
Yeah. Yes, I was long before you.
See,
yeah.
I was slow. I had to do a little math. I'm like, no,
I
you were
not.
Easily 61. Easily 61.
And things right now are wonderful again in St. Paul at that fabulous hotel because of It's a Wonderful Life. Jim, describe what goes on with this show. Because a lot of folks, for me, mandatory to see the movie, the Jimmy Stewart movie, every year.
Sure.
Gots to be done.
Yeah.
But this is a different version and will please those who love the movie.
Yeah, I think it does. It's very, very faithful to the movie version. Yeah, my deal with the movie is I don't think anybody really watches it anymore. I think it's sort of on in the background while you're doing other stuff, whether it's decorating your tree or making cookies or whatever. Mm-hmm. Jimmy Stewart is on in the background, and you don't really focus on it. You turn to it like when the hand comes into the Yule log. You turn, oh, here's that thing. Watch that now. Watch it. Hot dog. And then you're back to whatever you're doing.
You're dead on.
Yes.
So you know, I was a cop for all these years, and I always worked on Christmas. And the only reason I know anything about this movie is all the cops always had it going in the back. You go in for a break or whatever. And
those were the good cops, by the way.
The only reason we know the movie at all is because of that. It was going on at Christmas time. The rights on it lapsed, and so it went into the Freebill.
It was an easy fill for the TV station.
So they plug it in so that people, you know, you could be down to one person, right? And but so that's the only reason we know it, because there's lots of great Christmas movies.
And by the way, the cops who watched It's a Wonderful Life are the good cops. The bad ones were watching this one. It's how you could tell the bad cops in Roseville.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch.
If you heard that coming from a squad island.
This should be my theme song. This should really, I love this.
Did you like the Grinch, Chuck?
Yeah, I associate with the Grinch.
I like it.
I should get a Grinch tattoo.
Let's get back to the
Sorry,
Grinch.
Sorry, man.
That is one of my favorite Christmas movies.
Is it?
The Grinch
it's great. The cartoon is good.
Yeah.
The Ron Howard movie with Jim Carrey's.
And The Nightmare Before Christmas.
That's a good one, Tim Burton.
Even though it's kind of more of a Halloween-y one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, my favorite is it's a Wonderful Life. So the way you guys present it is kind of a radio show, is that right?
Yeah, it's like you're walking back in time to 1946, and you are seeing a live radio broadcast emanating from the Promenade Ballroom of the St. Paul Hotel.
Here, listen to this. 1 second.
In the Twin Cities.
Say, look where
So that was the radio show?
Yeah. This is our show. You're listening to it right now. We've actually changed our call letters now in the last couple of years. Can I talk about the radio station that we're working with?
Yeah, please do.
WCCO is our radio partner. We love them too, and so now we sing. It really was. It was the goal 10 years ago when we started, was to work with CCO on it, and last year CCO broadcast our Saturday night show. And then rebroadcast it on Christmas Eve. But they took it live, and they sent Mike Lynch and John Williams down there.
Dude.
And, it was just terrific.
Is that happening again?
Yeah,
it's happening again.
The 19th of December, you can listen to it live on CCO at 7 o'clock, 8:30 a.m., obviously. And then they'll rebroadcast it on Christmas Eve, although I don't know. I have no idea what the timing is.
Forget
that.
The Yule log. This is a cool tradition that's beginning.
It is. It's a really neat thing. The cool part about the show is you're going to get the show that you like, but you have to watch it. We're turning down the lights, and you give it your focus, and it hits you in a completely different way, because it's not Jimmy Stewart, and it's not Donna Reed. It's these other people, and you just don't see it coming as clearly as you do because you know the movie backwards and forwards.
Yeah.
This thing unfolds in a different way. We got a live sound effects guy over here doing, you know.
So like Prairie Home Companion, if you've been to that show.
Yeah, it's a little bit. Yeah, a little bit like that. It's a little bit like Prairie Home Companion. This version of it, It's a Wonderful Life, a live radio play, is playing all across America. There's versions of this. The guy who came up with this idea lives in lives out east on the East Coast, and created this because he was working for a theater company that wanted to do a stage version of Wonderful Life. And when they started talking about the intricacies of snowstorms and stuff, he said, "Well, what if we did it like this?" And it
Genius.
Caught on.
Yeah.
And it
it's a smart. That's a smart take.
Really,
on it.
Really, really cool. And so our version of it is a little different than anybody else's. And I think right now we are the longest running version in America at the St. Paul Hotel.
How many years then?
This is 10. This is our 10th anniversary. So, and you get the show, you get a whole bunch of Christmas carols before the show, the kind that, you know, that were sung by Bing Crosby and the Andrews Sisters in the 40s.
Yeah, yeah.
Then you get your dinner or your lunch if you come to the matinee.
Sweet.
And there's enough time in between the acts for you to sort of enjoy the people that you came to the show with. It's not like really just going to a show or a movie where you all file in like we did on Friday at The Sound of Music, which is great. You file in, you sit in the dark. When it's over, you say, thanks, see you later.
Yeah, yeah.
This gives you room in the show. It's built in where you have a chance to really celebrate with the people you came with, and it's terrific.
Do you find that motivates talk about Christmas conversation then, since that's what it's all around you?
Yeah, a lot of people come and
celebrate. So, Chuck, you would love it.
Yeah,
yeah.
It's,
oh, God,
it's all for you.
For
Chuck,
sure.
This is your show.
Yeah, thank you. And you know, I don't think I'm disparaging this, because it is on my list of movies that I should see and actually watch.
Yeah.
Because it looks like a great movie, and it transcends religion and all that stuff. It's just, let's face it, Christmas is kind of a secular holiday.
Well, so. It certainly is in this movie, I think. I mean, when I say that, of course, we all know he prays and an angel comes down from heaven to help him. So it may not be as secular as you think.
Could you tell me what minute mark that is so I can just leave and get some gobstoppers?
It's in the first quarter.
I was going to say, it's in the first 30 seconds.
Oh, we're good. We're good.
But the message that Capra wanted to get across is a secular message that we as people need to take care of each other, and that it all of the messages that in Capra's films are about that. They're about us as, and specifically us as Americans, needing to, we can get through this thing. We just have to stick together.
Yeah. I love that movie. Has so many great moments that give me emotional.
Yeah.
Here's a moment from the movie where he's Jimmy Stewart is an architect who's given up on a lot of his dreams because of family obligations and doing the right thing. And then he meets his gal, Mary, and this is kind of their stumbling first date moment. Hold on.
Mary, I know what I'm going to do tomorrow and the next day and next year and the year after that. I'm shaking the dust of this crummy little town off my feet, and I'm going to see the world. Italy, Greece, the Parthenon, the Colosseum. Then I'm coming back here and go to college and see what they know. And then I'm going to build things. I'm going to build airfields. I'm going to build skyscrapers 100 stories high. I'm going to build bridges a mile long. Were you going to throw a rock?
She throws a rock in an old house.
That's pretty good.
It's good luck.
What'd you wish, Mary?
They're Jewish, Mary.
Did he just say you're Jewish, Mary?
Anyway.
What happened there?
Isn't that what he said? They're Jewish, Mary?
No.
You can't throw the rock at the Jewish house, eh?
No. You just have to see the movie. It's fantastic. You guys all.
That's what he said. That would have been funnier. They're Jewish, Mary.
Again, I see this movie every year quite often. I see it by myself because my family is horrible.
I guess you can go to my house if you want.
Yeah.
Or better yet, meet me at the St. Paul Hotel.
Yeah, Jennifer and I will be drunk in some secular bar somewhere.
Yeah.
Martinis.
Yeah.
The show is doing quite well, but there are some tickets still available. What's the best way to do this?
Yeah, there are a couple of ways you can do it, but you got to do it fast. We're doing 17 performances. Wow. 11 of them are completely sold out.
Good
and
for
the
you.
Others are down to limited availability, which means you actually have to call. You can't order tickets online anymore, but you can look at some stuff at stpaulhotel.com.
Okay.
But then you can give them a call.
We'll hook up this number to our site right now.
The number to call for tickets is 651-228-3860. 651-228-3860.
Yeah, we're posting it right now. That's how magical we are. And otherwise, you can tune into CCO on
yeah,
December.
You can, and that really might be your best option at this point, unless you act now. And I'm not kidding.
Yeah.
We've never, it really has found its audience because we've never been this sold out this early.
Cool.
So there are more people in
yes,
St. Paul, apparently.
On the good team.
Yes. Who are.
These two, Jennifer and Chuck, who obviously are on the Grinch team.
The tickets went on sale in August. And,
wow.
And they blew out the doors on it. So
wow.
It's really crazy. Really fun.
Well, you're someone who's used to long-running shows because let's before we we're pushing up on a break here. Tony and Tina's wedding. How long?
Yeah.
How long was that gig?
I did 2 years, I think.
Only 2 years?
Yeah, I did the first 2 years, and then I would still come back when they got into a real jam.
You were like the Elvis of Tony and Tina.
Yeah.
I always thought of you when I thought of Tony and Tina's wedding.
I appreciate that, but there were a lot of great people that played that role. In fact, right from the gate. Ross Young, who directed the show, played Tony with me. So there were nights when I couldn't do the show for one reason or another.
Drugs.
I didn't want to say that so cleanly. But yes, that's, of course, exactly it.
Well, it was paint huffing, not really drugs.
No,
so.
No.
But that was a heck of a
You're
time.
You're still high, though.
That run was very, very cool. I went to the show a couple times. I got to play your best man at the State Fair show.
Yeah.
That was weird. In daylight in front of thousands of people.
It was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
World's largest chicken dance. I don't know if we still hold the record.
But yeah.
For a while, it was a Guinness Book of World Record. But you know what is interesting? In this show that I'm doing at the St. Paul Hotel, Ross is in it.
Oh.
He plays, he combines Mr. Potter and Clarence the Angel.
Okay.
One of the groomsmen is in it with me. He's the sound guy.
Oh, cool.
And up until this year, she had to have surgery and can't do the show. But for 9 years, the woman who played Tina was in it with me.
Oh,
so,
wow.
Yeah.
What's her name?
Jennifer Edwards.
And she's doing well?
Yes, she is.
Surgery?
Yeah, okay, yeah, she is. I don't know if you know about Ross, but this is a really emotional year for all of us because Ross, who shared the role of Tony with me and directed that show and has been in our show for 10 years, and we do another show together during the summer at Brit's Pub called The Complete Works of William Shakespeare, Abridged, all 37 plays in 97 minutes by three guys in tights.
Oh, God, that's got to be good.
It is. It's a lot of fun. We do it Sundays in July.
Can we go to that?
Pub. It's free.
It's free.
Yeah.
It's at Brit's. They have beer.
Yeah. We got it.
You were saying, though?
Yeah, August 6th, he had a cardiac arrest and died.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, no.
And the Crystal Police Department got him to the hospital, and he died again and was in a medically induced coma for several days, and they did not expect him to recover. He's just closed one show
he
was in at Camp Bar.
Wow.
And now he's in Don't Hug Me, A Christmas Carol, down at the downtown Minneapolis.
Is it at the Brave New Workshop? Or
No, it's I'm trying to think. New Century. It's called New Century. It's right there in City Center.
Wow.
And now we'll start rehearsal for our show Sunday night of this week, the 6th of December.
That's amazing.
Yeah. So it's a miracle by anybody's estimation. A miracle. The man, by anybody's estimation. Mm-hmm. The doctors, the cardiac surgeons, the intensive care nurses. It's a flat out miracle. He should be dead. And if he isn't dead, he should be in a home somewhere eating
out
very
of context,
soft food.
That sounds terrible. He should be dead.
But he's not. He's here. And that's
and he'll be part of the show.
Yeah, he's in the show.
So he's got his own angel
exactly.
Looking out for him. You're bringing up summary thoughts, which is nice because we're in for the long winter haul now. But we see you at the Twins games.
Yeah, and the Minnesota Wild games. So I do both.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So, yeah, you're out there giving away prizes and
goofing around with people.
It's got to be fun, right?
It's terrific. This will be 20 years, provided I'm on the sidelines or outside the white lines at Target Field in April. You know, I never know. I never count it until I'm actually standing there. Uh-huh. But if it happens, then that's 20 years for me.
Wow.
Yeah.
I didn't realize you had been doing that gig for that long.
Yeah. 20
wow.
years.
Wow. Well, yeah, don't pull a Ragnar, man.
No, I'm trying not to. That's not my...
I demand 20,000 for an appearance. I'm Jim Cunningham. Have you seen me in tights? I wear tights man, very well.
I fill them out.
In the back.
Hey, are you able, though, to even...
Well, now I'm going to look.
Enjoy the game? Are you even...
I enjoy the fans. Yeah, yeah. No, not the in hockey. Yeah. Same deal. It's just very difficult.
You're moving. You got a place to be. Moving around. Got moments to hit.
People are talking, so I hear the cheer, and then I'll try to get to a place where I can see what happens.
Oh, that grand slam! Wasn't that great, Jim? What grand
Dang
slam?
It. Yeah. Dang it!
I have no idea what you're talking about.
What's a grand slam? Denny's. So,
but I have a good time talking. You know, I just chat with people. I sit wherever there's a seat. I'll go sit, and we'll do what we're doing from wherever we are, and then there's a chance to chat with people, and that's a lot of fun.
Well, just so you know, the Wild, we have high hopes for them. So
I do too. Really do. Yeah.
Which one is that? Hockey?
Whoops. Yeah,
that's the hockey one.
That's your local basketball team. You should know.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
No. So are you basketball. A hockey fan? You say you skate.
Yeah. I did not play hockey as a kid, and I wouldn't say a big hockey fan before I started working for the Wild 15 years ago, but the game has certainly grown on me, and yeah, I like it quite a bit.
Is there a way when you're in the crowd to get your attention and be part of the bit?
Well, I can tell you now, this year it's a little different. We're doing a new thing called Wild Vision. So there's two of us at a desk at the beginning of the game, and we're in section 123. You can stop by anytime and say hi. We're kind of locked down. We'll go down on the ice in between periods, but we're right there. So people, in the old days, we were up in the press box. We'd go down the back stairs to the ice and come back up. So there wasn't a lot of chance to chat with people. But now there is. We're right there in section 123.
Section 123. Okay.
No, that's good. You're getting more interactive with your crowds.
Yeah.
That's the best way to do it.
It really is. It's the key, I think. The Twins kind of pioneered that, believe it or not, 20 years ago, the idea of having somebody go into the stands.
See, I just assumed that was a whole Saints thing, that they were borrowing.
Yeah. I don't,
did you do the Saints as well?
No, I did not. Yeah, no. I went right to the major leagues.
You went right to the major. Nice, smart move. Very smart move.
I was. It was. You know who was supposed to do it? Dark Star.
Ooh.
Dark Star was supposed to do it. The Twins had conceived this idea to send a guy into the stands on Friday nights to play trivia. And when they eventually sold the element, they sold it to Old Chicago Pizza.
Yeah.
And Dark said, "Hey, I got to non-compete with Devonnie's. I can't be any part of that." And I was doing radio spots for the Twins at that point, and I knew the guy who was in charge, and he called me up and said,
"That's a no-brainer.
We got no money."
Yeah.
So let's not get to no-brainer that quickly. But he said, "We got no money because CCO was supposed to provide the talent."
Yeah.
But I know you like baseball. I'll give you tickets to any game you want, short of a World Series.
Yeah.
And I'll buy you dinner every Friday night. And I said, yeah, I'll do it. Yeah. So I used to take my tuxedo home from Tony Tina's wedding on Thursday nights and go to the park on Fridays and do this thing, and then Ross would do Tony that night.
Oh.
And 20 years later, but so if Dark Star, if they'd sold it to, let's say, Haskell's Wine and Spirits,
yeah,
I would not have a major league career.
Well, you do a great job, and it's not easy. You're hustling, but I think I went to two Twins games and only made it to two this year. But one of them, you were literally like 15 feet away, and I was like, "I want to win something." Jim, Jim, over here, I want to win something.
You can fly me underneath the flagpole.
All right, we're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back. Stay tuned.
The Twin Cities Hit Show. We'll be right back.
Third Street Brewhouse, built on a perfect site in Cold Spring, Minnesota. Combining the state-of-the-art brewing facility with exceptional water. Hello, did we mention Cold Spring, Minnesota? They have a dream team of world-class brewers, resulting in unprecedented crafted beers. The core styles of Bitter Black IPA, Lost Trout Brown Ale, and Rise to the Top Cream Ale are intriguing yet satisfying. And look forward to seasonal and specialty beers. Nothing fancy, no fuss. It's all about the beer at Third Street Brewhouse.
MacMen. Don't let your computer problems drive you mad. We are MacMen, Minnesota's premier tech consultants and problem solvers for Macs, mobile devices, troubleshooting, training, and much more. No more dragging your computer all over town, because we come to you. We love making house calls to your home or small business. MacMen. Call 612-345-8005.
The Rusty Gatenby Review is the entertaining show about entertainment from movies, music, and more. Award-winning TV guy Rusty Gatenby and his review is the podcast with the biggest cast in entertainment, part of the Alive and Social Network. You can get that Minnesota connection to Hollywood and beyond any time of the day or night simply by clicking on the RustyGatenbyReview.com. That's the RustyGatenbyReview.com, part of the Alive and Social Network.
Introducing the Twin Cities' newest transportation app, Cruise. C-R-U-Z, with no surge pricing ever.
Cruise to that brewery.
Cruise to that concert.
Cruise to that ball game.
Cruise home from that party.
I like Tom Cruise.
No kidding.
I do.
Sensing a pattern? Cruise. That's C-R-U-Z, the new app that saves you money with no surge pricing ever. Book in advance and save even more with Cruise. Download the Cruise app. Follow him on Twitter at Time to Cruise to get weekly ride discounts.
Whenever you booze, use Cruise.
Download Cruise right now on iOS or Android.
There aren't many kids across the globe who have Ender's rare cancer.
That's special.
Very special. Which is why his family travel overseas to send you Children's Research Hospital. Doctors across America and around the world send St. Jude their toughest cases. We freely share our research to help kids everywhere.
Even South America?
Yes, where you live and wherever you live.
Donate now at stjude.org or shop wherever you see the St. Jude logo.
You're listening to the Twin Cities Hit Show.
Say it three times fast. We just dare you.
Baby, what you doing now? You're pissing me off.
So Colleen Justice would normally be here, and she's a huge fan of It's a Wonderful Life. Jennifer, my lovely wife, is here in taking her place this morning, doing a great job. You can't hear anything. You don't have a headset on.
No, I can hear it.
Oh, you can hear it.
Oh, yeah.
We were watching the first Rocky over the weekend.
That was great.
The details of that movie, the first Rocky. Of course, Creed is out over the weekend. It came at number three. But there was a scene in there where...
The rape scene?
Where he's kissing Adrian for the first time. And he's like, you know, begging her to come up to his... Come on up. Come on up. He takes his shirt off. He's got the Marlon Brando wife beater on.
With a hole in the bottom.
He puts arms on either side of her and quarters her. And she's like, I gotta go. Jennifer's like... This is a Rocky rape scene.
This is rape.
I feel a little rapey.
Yeah, exactly.
She's like, Adrian. I hardly know you.
So for the rest
of the
movie, it was about remember when I raped you?
But Colleen, I'd forgotten that was in there. Colleen and I both agree one of our favorite scenes is when George is on the phone and he's getting a deal from Plastics. What's his name is calling?
Sam Wainwright.
And
I play Sam Wainwright.
Oh, you do?
And
So
in our version...
Kind of obnoxious guy there. Typecast.
Yeah, but who at the end?
That's true.
Hee-haw, Merry Christmas.
Spoiler alert. Okay, go on.
So in our version, George, the guy who plays George Bailey and the woman who plays Mary Bailey, those are the only roles they play. Uh-huh. Then the rest of us, there's four of us, play
the other.
Everybody else in Bedford Falls.
That's cool.
So the whole rest of the town and the crowd scenes and all of that is done by the rest of us.
So when you're in the audience, you see that magic happen on stage. Oh, now he's got a different voice and listen to that different accent, whatever. And then if you're listening at home, it just sounds like a cast of hundreds.
Yeah. But that's so the difference is if you're listening at home on the CCO night, you get that experience.
Yeah.
And it's fun in its own right. If you come, you see all of the craziness that goes on as we're whipping around and changing and sound effects are live. It's fun.
Well, here's it's not a rape, but here's the scene from It's a Wonderful Life where George pretty much starts shaking Mary. He can't control himself.
A little Mary. Domestic abuse.
Mary.
Well, I'm here.
Will you tell that guy I'm giving him the chance of a lifetime? Do you hear? The chance of a lifetime.
Now there's just tension.
It's the chance of a lifetime.
They're so close. Nose to nose. Drops the phone.
Now you listen to me.
He's shaking her now.
I don't want any plastics. I don't want any ground floors. And I don't want to get married ever to anyone. You understand that? I want to do what I want to do. And you're...
Oh.
George.
I love that scene.
Yeah.
It is borderline...
aggressive. Right? Wow. Am I right? I'm right. I think it's one of the most romantic scenes.
I think it's one of the most romantic scenes.
I do.
Mary, you're a rag doll.
Like, she's like, you told me to tell you it's an opportunity of a lifetime. Oh, God.
What's wrong with
it's gorgeous. I mean, not gorgeous, but it's the tension in there. So do you do that scene?
We do everything. The only thing we don't do is the swimming pool.
Yeah, I was going to say, you can't
short of that, we do it all. All there.
With the cameo by Alfalfa
in
the movie.
Nice.
I got to watch this.
So, George Bailey is in Bedford Falls this morning. Is that right?
He's at the dentist in Bedford Falls this morning, but he's not coming to Minneapolis until Sunday.
Can we give him a call and see if he's out of the dentist office? Chuck,
if he's available.
Call George Bailey. Oh, this is fantastic. Wow. I wonder if it's snowing. This time of the year, it's got to be snowing in Bedford Falls, you would think.
I think it's almost always snowing in Bedford Falls.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, of course, our live audience doesn't hear the ringing, so we need to talking.
No, you can push it in. Push it in.
It's ringing.
Yeah,
it's
ringing. They can hear the ringing.
Yeah.
There we go. It's more dramatic.
It's more dramatic.
I hope he answers.
This is George Bailey. I'm at the dentist. The dentist!
Well, maybe it's not so wonderful for
him. It's a wonderful life, but I got to
You reached your calendar.
Someone took George's phone, even.
He must have had a cavities.
In actuality, that is the guy who's been playing the role all 10 years.
Yeah, all 10 years. He lives in we started, obviously, all of us, when we started, lived here in Minneapolis. But the guy who plays George relocated to New York and is working as an actor out there now.
I hear they have theaters in New York.
My understanding is there's some good ones.
Wow. Yeah.
And then the woman who plays Mary Bailey got married and is working as an actress in Atlanta, Georgia.
Wait.
And they both come back to do this show.
She didn't remain single and become a librarian?
No. She. It turns out... Spoiler alert.
It turns out all right. Before I leave the Rocky thing, do you have any interest in seeing this new Rocky movie, Creed?
I'm going to see it tonight, as a matter of fact.
It's really good.
I'm a huge Rocky guy.
Good.
I watched all five of them, plus Rocky Balboa, in the last 2 months, just to get ready for this. I'm not a big Rocky Balboa guy. A lot of people are. I think the fifth movie is as good or better than Rocky Balboa.
Wow.
Yeah, I like the fifth movie.
Wow, because that's the one that gets ripped the most.
Yeah, I know. The one that should get ripped the most is the fourth movie, which I think is a piece of crap.
Which one is that?
The Dolph Lundgren one.
That's where he fights the Russian. The first movie won the Academy Award.
Yeah, best picture.
The second movie was every bit as good as the first, I think, as a sequel.
Yeah.
The third movie, we start to get into a weird place a little bit, but
cartoony.
Still.
Cartoony.
Yeah,
still get you got
solid.
Mr. T.
Yep.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. Yeah.
And then the fourth movie sucked. The fifth movie, I thought, redeemed itself. I saw an interesting deal with him. If you see the Rocky Balboa movie, he said, I was done. Yeah. I was done with the character. In that Rocky Balboa movie, you'll see, I'm in a cemetery, and I turn and wave and just disappear. And that was it. I was done. I was never going to do anything with Rocky again. And then these people approached me.
Oh, and it's great.
Yeah, I mean, here. Did you see it?
Yeah, I've done my reviews on it already. It's the best one since the first. Yeah. I give it 4 out of 4 stars.
I'm going tonight. I'm going to see it in Green Bay, Wisconsin.
Well, I'm so excited. They're doing, I guess, the next one. They've already in their pre-production, but he battles ISIS.
Is that right?
So excited, yes.
Wow.
Really excited.
Well, this one is called Creed because Apollo Creed did an Adrian Peterson, evidently. His character had a child out of wedlock that he was unaware of, and that's who Creed is. Creed is also a band. Remember Arms Wide Open? And the lead singer is Scott Stapp. And he did a review of the movie.
Oh, he did?
You remember Arms Wide Open, right?
When I finally heard the news today.
Sing it, Chuck.
It seems my life is gonna change.
Sounds like Jimmy Stewart.
I close my eyes.
Well, so that's Scott Stapp singing. He's the lead singer of Creed, the band. Here's his review of the movie, Creed.
What's up? Scott Stapp here. Welcome to my movie review show. So this week, I checked out a new film called Creed. This movie has a lot of boxing. One time I punched a guy from 311, but I never actually boxed. Spoiler alert! Creed the movie has no epic guitar solos played on a mountaintop. And at no point does Creed sing on a steep cliff. That's what we do best. Then, out of nowhere, Creed is hanging out with Rocky Balboa. Take it straight from the guy from Creed. We never met Rocky Balboa. In one scene, Creed is in front of a huge crowd. And I was like, is he about to play Woodstock 99? Nope, just more boxing. I can't deny cinematographer Maurice Alberti paints Philadelphia as a gritty tapestry.
Now he just slides into a real review, but he never gives up the fact that he thought it was his story. Spoiler alert, we never met Rocky Balboa. Anyway, I think you'll like it.
I know I will.
And what's great is having watched the first one again, it does have more of those quiet moments. Plus, there's a boxing sequence in the middle. I'm not going to spoil it for you.
No, please.
I'm not going to spoil it for you.
Give me nothing.
It's you already spoiled
best,
it. I didn't expect
it's the
boxing
best sequence. Boxing sequence I've seen filmed. It's like, remember Birdman last year where the camera just continues to move?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
There's no edit. This is an entire round of boxing without one edit. So to choreograph it must have taken months. And it looks real, and as a viewer, you feel the intensity of being in the ring. It's fantastic.
Yeah, I would like to see that, because those are always filmed the same way and very cliche.
Yeah, I know. This one is really amazing. So you have to tell me how you like it.
I will love it.
Give me your
tell you right now.
Give me your review. Will you run up and down the steps of the cathedral in St. Paul?
It's more than possible.
Have you ever drank 12 raw eggs?
Three once. It's a bet.
Yeah. You've done, Jennifer, the
no,
raw eggs?
I was telling you, it was 5 raw eggs.
Oh, it was only 5. Okay.
It was only 5.
I counted.
Okay.
Have you ever done that in Philly where you run up the steps?
I went Donald Trump
That's
for
cool.
a second.
You ever do that, Rusty?
Do what?
You go to Philly and you run up the steps of the, is it art museum?
It's the art museum, yeah, I know.
Incredible. It's, I mean, I'm not a big Rocky fan, but I've been there and it's so cool to just run up those steps. You're like,
And there's a statue there, right?
Yeah.
I think they took it down.
Did they?
I think they might have.
Last time I was there, was that?
Was it there?
Yeah. Yeah. Really cool.
Well, today, friends, is Cyber Monday. Do we care about that? You've already started to shop online, haven't you, Jennifer?
No. I've been studying and playing online games.
Well, look at you. You nice. Is that our guy?
I'm getting a call from George Bailey even as we
George
speak.
George Bailey.
Tell him, hop on, I'll mute you for a second. And then,
okay.
All right. So George Bailey from Bedford Falls.
Yeah, we're going to have George. George Bailey. Wait, no. I missed it. I'm going to try calling him again here.
You sounded more like Mr. Potter than George Bailey there for a second.
I know. I lost my... Jimmy Stewart, see? He's Jewish, Mary. He's Jewish.
I like the phone ringing.
George Bailey. Bailey's sitting alone.
George. Yeah. George, how did the dentist visit go? Are you all right?
Well, I'm okay, but we're still there.
Oh wow!
Then you can't be that good.
Put the doctor on the phone. I want to verify this.
I hope he's not Dr. Potter.
No. I stay away from him.
So you literally are right now in the dentist chair.
That might be true, yes.
He's swallowing. That's what that...
How about that? This is commitment to a project, ladies and gentlemen.
No, it's all running down the front of my tie.
Is life wonderful besides being at the dentist?
Life is truly quite wonderful. Yes, thank you.
Can you feel the right side of your mouth right now?
Well, at least I'm not on a microphone, because that, with the drooling and the, like, there'd be some kind of risk of electrocution.
Do you like coming back to St. Paul for the holidays?
Oh, I it's my favorite thing. It's the best part of my year. It is the single greatest project I've ever been involved in.
And Rice Park, right? I mean, what a location. How can you not be in the Christmas spirit when you go to that area of
town?
Well,
and if you walk into the lobby of the St. Paul Hotel, I mean, it is Christmas. It's the land of Christmas. And if you can't, as you said, it is the most perfect place in the world to be for the holidays.
Have you ever gone to a production and been in a lousy mood, and then the show transforms you?
have I?
Yeah. Like, not tonight. I can't do it tonight. Yeah.
Are you asking your co-host? Or you asking him, Rusty? Because that's me every day.
You've never been on a bridge about to jump, and like, oh, it's showtime.
No, yeah, right, exactly. Well, there are higher fences now on the bridges.
Oh, okay. Did you have something to do with that? Well, we look forward to you got rehearsals coming up this weekend, right?
Yeah, I fly into town on Sunday, and we jump right into it, and
pull the
cast back together, and it's go time.
Rehearsal's got to be pretty easy. I mean, come on, 10 years. You know this gig, right?
Well, I got to say this. For me, once I start these after 10 years, I know this stuff backwards and forwards. And it's such a treat to be able to play this role that it's deep in my soul now, and even deeper in my brain. So,
your favorite moment? What's your favorite moment in the show?
My favorite moment in the show, and it's my favorite moment in the movie, is when my mother says to George, or to Harry, you know, near the end, she goes, "Harry, what about your banquet in Washington?" And he says, "I flew back the minute I heard, Mother."
Oh, yeah.
And that just always, I just go when I hear that.
Yeah.
It's just such a straightforward statement of when you care about somebody, there's no questions asked. You just take care of them.
Yeah. Well, take care of your teeth, damn it.
They'll take care of you.
I'll do my best.
He says that to everyone.
To the professionals.
He says that to everyone. It's not an insult to you.
All right. Jim, that was not George Bailey. Who are we talking with? That is
Phil
actor.
Callen, actor Phil. Extraordinaire. Ernie the cab driver will pick you up at the airport on Sunday morning.
I'll look forward to it. I'll recognize him by his horn.
That's exactly right.
All right. Thanks for taking a moment. Get back to work there.
Have a wonderful day.
Thank you.
Have a wonderful life.
He's good. I'm telling you, he's the best in the business.
Is there something in the contract where you have to say wonderful with every adjective possible?
I can't get into it with you.
Well, that sounds wonderful.
Yeah. It's a wonderful.
So anyway, today is Cyber Monday. We've got just a couple minutes left on this darn hit show.
Black Friday, as you know, is come and gone, and holiday shoppers are moving on to Cyber Monday, which is today. Americans are expected to spend more than $3 billion online. It's just another manic
Monday. Have you transitioned to the online bit, or do you have to go to the mall?
No, I do almost everything online. Almost everything online.
Wow.
Yeah. I will make a trip, I'm sure, to the mall at some point. I go to the Mall of America, and then I'll get to Roseville after I'm done skating at the Oval.
That was actually a small chapter in my life. So,
Am I alone then? I'm the only one who does not do the online shopping.
I think you are.
You're a techno. For a guy who's like so involved in tech, you're a technophobe.
I'm a technophobe. I am.
He's like, don't text me. That's so modern. Does he answer your text, Jennifer?
Yeah.
No. See? Yeah.
You know what's I guess the deal this Cyber Monday is actually our own target because everything is 15% off.
Just
store wide. So you don't have to shop for we only have four of these TVs.
Yeah.
As I hold up five fingers. Yeah. We only have four.
He's also good with math.
Four, I tell you.
Well, that is four fingers.
But the entire store. I saw in the reports that said for your online Cyber Monday, Target is actually the best deal because it's 15% off. You're saying that's a crappy
plus
deal?
Do you get free shipping if it's over $50?
That I don't know.
See, those are details I have to know.
Okay. Yeah, you got to lean into that, well, Mike.
Can you get it if you go into the store?
For me is the
I don't know. I think it was their online deal.
Okay.
I don't know.
I think you have.
I'll go into the store and call you.
But I don't know. Usually they have you can go in the store and pick it up, so they have your little order for you there when you get there, which is nice.
I like that.
What are the items this year? What's the hot? What's on your list? What the hell do you need for Christmas?
Oh, I don't need anything.
Yeah, right.
I just don't. I need very, very little. There's a book I want.
What's the book?
It's a book about Houdini. That
sounds cool.
Yeah. And then Springsteen.
What's it called?
It's called The Witch. I forget now. It's it just came out.
Oh.
It's late in his career when he is dealing with the spiritualists.
Wow.
And there was a woman in Boston named Marjorie, and it's a a true story about that. And then Springsteen just released a box set that I'm going to get for Christmas.
Oh. Sun Country is doing...
Write that down.
Sun Country, cyber specials on travel.
Oh, really? Yeah. What do they got?
You gotta you got to go to their website to see, but if you book by December 2nd, they're bragging up savings on packages, on coach and first class fare to U.S. And select international cities.
I love the Sun Country.
I do too.
Yeah. I'm doing a thing with them. They do like a flight to the North Pole every year.
Oh, yeah. They take the kids up.
They take the kids up. So I'm doing that next Wednesday, I think, the 8th.
Spoiler alert, that plane never leaves the ground.
Oh, kids.
It gets up into the clouds, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
Hey, Rusty. Santa's not real.
Hey!
Oh, come on.
What the?
Now we're going to have to edit this show. You know, just because you're blue and Jewish.
Bluish. I'm bluish.
You know what? I'm very impressed, sir. You've had a career that is all over. I mean, your resume just must be filled with... It must be a four-page resume. And then I did this, and then oh, by the way, the Renaissance Festival that, and the Twins this, and the Wild, and the this, and the that. And then the stripping, you still do that.
Well, not as many people want me for that anymore. But yeah, it's there's three kids at home, and they each insist on eating three times a day.
So. You had a business, you had a deal where you were making stuff out of the tarp from
the
dome.
Yeah, we still are. You can go to Duluth. Can I talk about that?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, go to DuluthPack.com, and you can get a bag that was made out of the original Metrodome roof, not the re-roof,
right?
But the original Metrodome roof, the one that ripped,
the one that collapsed
in the snowstorm. Uh-huh. They have got that. We have the material, and we ship it to them. They cut it up and they make it into bags, and they're sweet and they're hip and they're really, really strong. They've got a shelf life of 3,000 years. Don't leave them out in a blizzard.
Yeah.
I think we all know that. But other than that,
who was the guy you just sat down and went, this? We got to buy this material. It can be something.
Yeah, it was me that I was at Target Field, and it just hit me like a lightning bolt. Hey, if we bought that material, originally we were going to cut it up into, you know, just
for a souvenir.
Souvenir sizes and print something on it.
Yeah.
But it's Teflon coated fiberglass.
Wow. Yeah.
And so you can't, nothing will stick to it ink wise. And so then the project just sort of languished for a while. And one of the other guys that bought the fabric with me went on vacation. And there they are.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Fancy.
Chuck's online. Look at that, Jennifer. That looks pretty, right?
Yeah, they're gorgeous.
I can almost see Adrian Peterson running underneath.
And they're Teflon, so Teflon-coated. So if you spill anything on it, it's just wiping it off.
Wipe it off.
You know, and there's so many times, and there's chocolate
that
and lipstick
so awesome.
And all that crap inside.
And get this. They're guaranteed for life. Wow. Life.
Unlike the Metrodome.
Something bad happens. Send it back to Duluth Pack, and they'll
What will break first, your body or this bag?
Yeah. Exactly. Shelf life of 3,000 years, the material does.
So the stitching's good.
Yeah. You're going to be fine. You're just fine.
Was there a moment then, though, where you were sitting on a garage full of
it's more
fabric
than a garage.
Going?
It's more than a garage. We ended up with two semi-fulls. Jeez. When we went to the public sale, just like everybody else, and you were allowed to buy one pallet of the material.
Hmm.
And I was the first person at the sale, and I went to the guy who was the foreman of the job replacing the roof and said, can I buy it all right now? He said, nah, we know that there's at least 10 people coming. So.
Yeah.
And I said, well, at the end of this, if there's left over, what's going to happen?
Yeah.
Can I buy it then? He said, if you stay till noon when the sale's over,
whatever's
left, if you seriously want to buy it, I'll sell it to you. I said, okay. So I sat down on my pallet from 8 to noon and waited for it to be over. By 9:10, everybody who wanted fabric was gone. It was just me. At noon, he said, how much do you want? I said, I'll take it all. And I said, will there be any more? He said, no, there's not going to be any more. I said, well, listen, I'm going to give you my number. There's not going to be any more. I said, take my number just in case. He called me twice more. We ended up with two semi-trucks full of inner and outer fabric. And we're the only people with the inner fabric, which is what the bags are being made out of.
Wow.
I have an idea for the outer fabric, but it's a secret. I can't talk about
it. Yeah.
Car covers. Awesome.
Condoms.
What?
Car covers.
Condoms.
That is just, you are insanely, you're insane.
Well, the idea for the bags wasn't really my idea. My idea was to buy the fabric and figure something out.
Yeah, but still, who does that?
Yeah, well.
And to that level.
There were 10 of us. You know, there were 10 of us.
Yeah, but they bought itty bitty. You said two semis full. Bring it on.
Yeah, I figured it was worth the.
That's amazing.
Worth having. And we also bought the baggie that was in right field for all those years.
Wow.
We have that, too, and that's being
Do you have any of the urinal rice cakes? Because I want those.
Not from the Metrodome, but from actually from Lambeau. So if you're if you're interested, I only...
Oh, man.
That's why I'm going to Green Bay. I got to pick up more urinal cakes today.
What do those taste like? Are they good?
Oh, like boy. Chicken. It tastes a little bit like chicken.
Well, so we did it. We made it through the first... that wasn't even a blizzard. What was that? That was a
nothing.
That was a light introduction.
Playing my guy to get me out of here, too. It. You're playing my guy.
You got it. So, yes. The show, the first show is when? It's sold
the
out.
The 10th.
Yeah. So we got to call and find out when the show is.
Well, you can go to the website and you can see which shows are sold out, stpaulhotel.com, and which shows are at limited availability. Limited availability means you got to call. And that number is 65. I think it's on your website.
We got it up right now. You can go to our Facebook page. We'll put it on our website as well. Do you see it there, Chuck?
651-228-3860.
Yep. 228-3860 in the 651 area code.
And if you want Jim to do his exotic dancing, it's 1-800 North Pole.
Thank you. The pole always points north.
Hey, whoa, wow, hot deer.
Hello.
Hey.
When the pole starts pointing south, I'm going to give it up.
Yeah, I would. It's kind of sad. Thanks for coming in.
My pleasure.
Drive safe, everyone. Who do we got on tomorrow?
We have
comedian
Kristen Anderson to promote her upcoming event this week. She's got a comedy show coming up.
She does. Yeah. So she's funny?
Yeah, she's very funny.
Is it snowing right now? I can't see. It's behind me. No. Are we good to drive home?
Yeah. Yeah.
My 20-minute drive took us, what, an hour and a half?
An hour.
Seriously, my 25-minute drive took me 35 minutes. Yeah. This, I don't even know.
Were you on the lawn? Were you just leaving?
I was out front on the lawn, cheering my shorts, drinking a beer, waiting for you.
Well, crank the Christmas music because the season has begun. Jim and I are together on this. Join the crowd. Don't listen to Jennifer and Chuck. Crank that Christmas music. Merry Christmas, Jim.
Merry Christmas to you. Merry Christmas, you old building in law. Merry Christmas, everybody.